Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Shout to God, all you heavens, and clap your hands, you honor. Enter into His presence, exulting and singing for joy. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Know that God is our Father, He made us, we are His own. Come to Him with thanksgiving, extolling and blessing His name. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Merciful to us sinners, compassionate to His sons. He has sent His beloved to guide us in justice and peace. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise Him with four voices and sing to Him from the heart. Gather Christians together, together to joyfully sing. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise the Lord with the trumpet, who praises me with the drums. Celebrate with the cymbal, exalt Him with drum, pipe and string. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise Him, praise to the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to all those present here at the Church of Jesus, the Living Water, and alone in the parish of
the help of Christians, Bolio, St. George's, Grenada. And a very, very special welcome to all those joining us on whatever platform you are using. So our Mass today is specially offered as a Mass of Thanksgiving, and to ask for God's blessing, God's healing, God's strength and protection for Dolores, Delon, and Matthew John, as requested by our sister, Merle Adolphus. As we always do now, we call to mind our sins and so try to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. And when we think about the readings today, we perhaps should call to mind the times we thought ourselves better than others. Sin of pride, perhaps. We ask God for forgiveness for that. And for the times maybe that we have hurt others or damaged them in some way, by our words or by our actions. And for the times also that we fail to allow God to use us as His instruments to bring His love to others. And perhaps more especially, if we have given scandal in any way to little ones and led them to sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Christ.
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who, for the faith they profess, are accounted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Now, the first reading, you know, there's a lot of similarities, a lot of echoes to the world we live in today. In the days of the first reading, we had great powers like Assyria, Babylon, Egypt. In the world today, we have the United States and NATO, Russia and China. And then we have the other countries, the smaller, less powerful countries that suffer very much. In those days, we had the Kingdom of Judah, the Kingdom of Israel. But today we have Ukraine and Yemen, Afghanistan and Iraq. So God uses, God can use anything or anybody as his instrument, but we must remember that we are instruments of God and not let our pride, our arrogance, not let it take over and make us think that we are the ones calling the shots, that we are the ones determining the course of the world today. So let us listen to this first reading from the prophet Isaiah.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord of hosts says this: Woe to Assyria, the rod of my anger, the club banished by me in my fury. I sent him against a godless nation. I gave him commission against a people that provokes me, to pillage and to plunder freely, and to stamp down like the mud in the streets. But he did not intend this. His heart did not plan it so. No. In his heart was to destroy, to go on cutting nations into pieces without limit. For he has said, by the strength of my own arm I have done this, and by my own intelligence, for understanding is mine, I have pushed back the frontiers of people and plundered their treasures. I have brought their inhabitants down to the dust, as if they were a bird's nest. My hand has seized the riches of the peoples. As people pick up deserted eggs, I have picked up the whole earth. With not a wing fluttering, nor a beak opening, not a chirp. Does the act claim more credit than the man who wields it? Or the saw more strength than the man who handles it? It would be like the cuddle controlling the man who raises it. And so the Lord of hosts is going to send a wasting sickness on his stalwart warriors. Beneath his plenty, a burning will burn like a consuming fire. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. The Lord will not abandon his people. They crush your people, Lord. They afflict the ones you have chosen. They killed the widow and the stranger, and murdered the fatherless child. Will not abandon his people. As they said, the Lord does not see, the God of Jacob pays no heed. Mark this, most senseless of people, fools, when will you understand? The Lord will not abandon his people. Can he who made the air not hear? Can he who formed the eye not see? He who will train nations not punished? Will he who teaches men not have knowledge? The Lord will not abandon his people. The Lord will not abandon his people, nor forsake those who are his own. For judgment shall again be just, and all true hearts shall uphold it. The Lord will not abandon his people. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for revealing the mysteries of the kingdom to mere children.
Alleluia.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. The Gospel of the Lord. Yesterday, I don't know if any of you or many of you were watched on television, some of the pictures that have come back from this new telescope they put up in space called the James Webb Telescope, and some fantastic pictures which they say take us back to the very dawn, the very beginning of the universe, and amazing detail of galaxies, and so many galaxies beyond count. And one picture that really that impressed me a lot was they called it the Dance of the Five Galaxies. And oh my goodness, these five galaxies interacting and moving, and all that's bringing them together in that so-called dance, in their movement together, is something called gravity. There's something called gravity, and there's something called magnetism. There is a force that keeps galaxies together and keeps galaxies and planets and individual bodies, keep them moving in some kind of order, in some kind of attraction to each other. And I mean, it just boggles my mind when I think about it, and especially when you hear about the time it takes for these images, to reach Earth, it's just mind-boggling. But you know, for all the, I suppose, thousands or even millions of galaxies and planets around suns in the whole of the universe, so far, we have not seen one where there are creatures like us. Not in the whole universe, not one planet that's like ours, that sustains the kind of life that we have today. And, you know, it just gives a sense of the uniqueness. At least maybe sometime in the future, such a planet and such creatures will be uncovered. And wonderful if it happens. That'll be great. It'll raise a whole lot of other questions about the creation and God. But for the moment, we are unique, as far as we know, in the whole universe that God has created. And when we think of that force of gravity holding, that force that holds things in unison, that brings even whole galaxies together, but also keeps planets and other heavenly bodies moving in coordination and synchronized. Just the wonder of it. And it reminds us then of that force that keeps us together on earth, that keeps families together, that draws people together, that means that children are cared for, that means that friends socialize together. And that force that we call love. And we remember that St. John tells us that God is love. So we just have to try to go beyond the human constructs that we have in our minds about God. You know, we tend to make God made us in his image and likeness, but we want God in our image and likeness, and we tend to attribute to God some of the failings and the weaknesses perhaps, and the characteristics that we have as individual human beings. So just to realize that God is way beyond what we can ever imagine. And when we see these recent discoveries and these advances in science, they should open our minds and expand our minds and our hearts further to appreciate something of the fantastic, infinite goodness and graciousness of God. And when we think of God then, that God that's so way beyond our understanding, beyond our imagination, and that God became one of us, that God came down on earth, that God created us to enter into that dance of love. When we think of God, we think of Father, we think of God revealing himself to us as human beings, Son, and we think of the Spirit, God with us, God in us, God guiding us, God inspiring us, God creating us, God giving life. We think of Holy Spirit. And that dance of love between Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that infinity of love, and that we are invited into that we are part of that. And so Jesus said, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. You know, when we're filled with pride and arrogance and we think ourselves better than others, it's always good for us just to remember that that's what we are. Children dependent on this God, this infinite being that is love. How dependent we are on God and on each other. And so we just try to enter into that with the simplicity and with the innocence and with the naivete even of children, not trying to, yes, using our brains and our minds, using our understanding to try to grasp a deeper understanding, but also with the simplicity just to accept that we are loved, and we are loved by that God that created that whole universe, that each one of us is precious in his, her eyes. Each one of us is unique. Each one of us is special. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. So let us stand now for the prayers of intercession. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the wonder and the greatness. We thank you for the gift of wonder and awe in your presence. And as we come to see and to learn of and to appreciate the wonders of creation, we ask you to help us to understand the wonders of your love. Lord, hear us. Lord, we pray for the members of this parish who are of this community, Lord, in Lamode, who are confined to their homes and to whom you will come personally in the sacrament of the Eucharist today. We pray that your presence in the Blessed Sacrament may be to them a source of healing, of comfort, and of consolation. Lord, hear us. And we pray very specially this morning, Lord, for Dolores, Delon, and Matthew John, for whom this Mass is offered. Lord, we ask you to bless them, to grant them your healing, your strength, and your loving care and protection all the days of their lives. Lord, hear us. If anyone would like to make a prayer, I invite you to do so at this time. Heavenly Father, we place all these prayers before you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Father, Lord, we offer you our daily life. Father God, we offer you our flesh. Father, Lord, we give you all our daily works. Father, Lord, we give you all us praise. And I know that we will rise again, again. And I know we'll die but rise again. For I know he is the living yeast of life, and I know that life will rise again. Father, take our life so small we give to you. Father, take the bread we offer you. Father, raise the banquet which the priest is now giving. Father, take the love we offer you. And I know that we will rise again, again. And I know we'll die but rise again. For I know he is the living yeast of life, and I know that life will rise again, and I know that life will rise again.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Clyde Martin our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And now, at the Father's command, at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Our kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. And now let's offer each other a sign of peace. And peace to all those joining us on whatever platform you're with us, wherever you are. May God's peace be with you at this time.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy.
The Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Safe for eternal life. Amen.
Rest in awe, and I will rest in awe.
my blood is drink indeed. He who eats of my flesh and drinks of my blood abides in me. And I will rest him up, and I will rest him up, and I will rest him up.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. And have a blessed rest of the day, everybody.
Thank you, Father.
I know nothing of tomorrow, and certain love of God will rise before the sun. The love of God will rise before the sun. Nations shake and earthquake, clouds tend to gather. Trouble seems as deep and black as night. Shades of gloom and threats of doom I see, but I would rather watch the darkness fade in morning's light. I know nothing of tomorrow, except the love of God will rise before the sun. The love of God will rise before the sun. Chill and wait until creation wakes and dances with the light that shines the wonderland. I know nothing of tomorrow, except the love of God will rise before the sun. The love of God will rise before the sun. Come along and sing a song and fill the world with laughter. Trust in Him who's won the trust of them. With heads on high against the sky, we pick what comes and after. Smile to feel the warmth of love again. I know nothing of tomorrow, except the love of God will rise before the sun. The love of God will rise before the sun. Before the sun.
stand before you,
Holy Spirit,
as we gather together in your name.
With you alone
to guide us,
make yourself at home in our hearts.
Teach us the way we must go
and how we are to pursue it.
We are weak and sinful.
Do not let us promote disorder.
Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path.
Nor partiality influence our actions.
Let us find in you our unity,
so that we may journey together to eternal life
and not stray from what is truth and what is right.
All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time.
In communion of the Father and the Son,
forever and ever.
Amen.